Hello my dear students, welcome again for the online classes. Today we will start with the same lesson of geography, our changing earth. We have started with the topic major landforms. In that, yesterday we have studied about the work of the river, how the river forms the different landforms on the earth surface. Today we are going to study about the work of the sea waves, how the sea waves form the different landforms like sea caves, sea arches, stacks, sea cliffs, and how the beaches are formed. Now let us see one by one. When the sea waves, when they continuously strike on the rock, the cracks are developed. And every time the small pieces of rocks get deposited in the sea, and over a time it becomes larger and wider. Thus the hollow shape is formed, which is called the sea caves. Now the because of the continuous striking of the sea waves, a shape is created like a cave in the rock, and which is called the sea caves. Then as the time goes slowly and gradually, because of the continuous erosion and deposition, the sea waves keep striking on the stone. These gap becomes wider and wider, and the rocks get deposited in the sea, and only the roof of the rock is left, and this shape of the rock is called sea arches. So this way the sea arches are formed. Further, the erosion breaks these rocks more. This way the waves keep on striking on the stone, and this part of the rock also gets eroded and deposited, and the rocks left are of this shape, and this shape of the rock is called the stacks. Means the roof which was left over is also getting eroded by the sea waves, and on this shape of the rocks is called the stacks. Now the shape, this point, when this type of rocks, when it stands, this point is called the sea cliffs. This rocky coast is exactly above the sea, and it is called the sea cliffs. Where this eroded material goes? So these sea waves carry with them sand, silt, and the small sediments of the rocks which are deposited in the sea. So these waves bring the eroded material and they put here on the seashore, and this eroded material forms the sea beaches on the seashore. So this way the beaches are formed on the seashore because of the eroded. So in short, we can say the beaches are formed by the eroded material by the sea waves. So children, this is about the work of the sea waves. Let us move towards the another agent, that is work of ice. Now let us start with the another point, that is work of ice. Now how does the ice forms the various landforms? First of all, let us see what are glaciers. Glaciers are the river of ice. Glaciers, when they move down from the mountain, they erode the landscape by bulldozing the soil and the other rocks which are coming in the way. Glaciers, when they move down, they erode the soil and the rocks, and the hollow space is formed here on the way. And when the ice melts, it gets filled with the water, thus forming the lakes, beautiful lakes in mountain. When they move
they erode the sand, silt, and then the small and the big rocks which are coming, and while moving they erode these particles at the other places, and these places in the mountains are called glacier moraines. Glacier moraines are the deposited material which are brought down by the glacier. This way the ice forms the glaciers, the beautiful lakes in the mountain, and the glacier moraines. These three landforms are formed by the work of ice. Now let us move toward the last one, that is the work of wind. Winds act as a active agent of erosion in the deserts, that is in the sandy area. When the wind blows, it leaves and transports the sand from one place to another. And when the speed of the wind changes, when the speed is very fast, it erodes the sand and it takes the sand to the another place. But when the speed decreases, when the speed of the wind decreases, it starts depositing at the lower plains, and thus the wind starts depositing at the lower plain, thus forming the low hills. The structure created is called the sand dunes. Now you have studied about the sand dunes. What are sand dunes? Sand dunes are the small hills of the sand. Now when the grains means the particles in the sand are very fine and lighter, so these particles are carried by the wind to a long distance and they deposit at a place. The structure formed here by the particles of the soil is called the dunes. The Gobi Desert in China is made up of the large deposits of the soil called the dunes. So these two structures are formed by the wind. Now the third one is the mushroom rocks. How the mushroom rocks are formed? Another structure formed by the wind. When the wind blows, it blows to the lower part. Now see children, when we are standing and when the wind comes, it strikes at the lower part of our body. It doesn't strike mostly here. It strikes at the lower part of the body. Same way, the wind strikes the lower surface of the earth. Thus, the wind erodes the lower surface of the earth, thus forming the shape of a mushroom. And thus, the rocks form like this shape are called the mushroom rock. Finally children, we have completed the lesson. Now what we have studied in this lesson, let us take a short glimpse. So in this lesson we have studied about the movement of the lithospheric plates, we have studied about the endogenic and the exogenic forces, how the changes are formed on the earth's surface because of these forces. Then we have studied about the volcano and the earthquake in the sudden forces. Then we have studied about the major landforms, and in the major landforms we have studied how the work of the river, work of the sea waves, work of ice, and the work of wind form the different landforms on the earth's surface. So children, this is about our changing earth, how our earth changes into different forms. So children, read the lesson thoroughly and try to understand the concept. Thank you.